Hey guys. It says I'm live, but I have a zero. Oh, hello. I am presently in Washington, D.C., on my way to New York for WrestleMania, but with a pit stop here because I had a very special day with Child Help, who most of you know that Child Help is an organization. I can't even speak. I'm so like, I've had such an emotional day. It's an organization that I've been very adamant about supporting and really trying to share with you all. And today we came to speak to members of Congress and the Senate about the CAPTA Act, about the, you know, changing the laws for child abuse and victims of child abuse and also to help with this child abuse hotline that that Child Help uses to not only help children of child abuse, but also to prevent child abuse from happening. And they've just launched this amazing, they've just launched a text app, which obviously we live in a world of technology where sometimes it's easier for people to text you some random stranger or something very personal than it is to, you know, tell someone that they love. And, you know, child abuse is so awful and it's happening every day in our country and all over the world. And every day, 5 children that we know of that are reported die from child abuse, from neglect, from abuse, from, you know, and countless others that go unreported. And, for most of you know, like this very, like it hits hard home and hits home with me very, very much. And, so I'm just trying to do everything I can to be an advocate and to be a voice for these children who are too afraid to say or to speak up. And, it's been an amazing day, and to be here on Capitol Hill with Child Help and to advocate for, you know, not only like the revision of this CAPTA so that way we can help continue to, you know, help more children and prevent more cases like this from happening. But just the awareness of like to see how many people are a part of this organization, but are also a part of this amazing movement to end child abuse forever. Hopefully that's my hope, and to, you know, make these children, you know, to bring them to a level to where they are no longer victims, but they are survivors and they are victorious, you know, in their own fight. And really, that's all they really need is hope and belief, and not just belief in, you know, that things can be okay and that they can be normal again, but more just belief in themselves and that they deserve to be loved. And, that's always the hardest battle. And I think, you know, we all deserve love, right? Like we all deserve love and to be loved. And, it just breaks my heart, you know, it breaks my heart so much. But anyway, I just want to tell you guys how much fun I had today and how special it was to me. And, so as I sit here and prepare myself to drive to New York and get ready to do all that, this is a big week ahead. I don't know if you heard. I just wanted to share that with you. And I implore you to, if nothing else, just go to childhelp.org and see what they do and see how amazing they are. And that's all. That's all.